Hey everyone, in this video, we are going to go through and solve a linear system of equations using the Gauss-Seidel method in Google Sheets. If you missed our previous video on the theory behind the Gauss-Seidel method, I would recommend you check out that video first, and I will leave a link in the description below for you to do so. As a summary, when using the Gauss-Seidel method, we need a square matrix that is linear, and we ideally want it to be diagonally dominant. Alright, so we are given this matrix here. And let's say that we want to see how many iterations it'll take us to achieve a solution accuracy of 0.005 for all of our independent equations. So, where do we begin? Well, although not necessary, it is wise to check if our matrix is diagonally dominant. I have proven this matrix is diagonally dominant in another previous video, in which we solved this problem by hand. So, if you are interested in why this matrix is considered diagonally dominant, check out that video in the description below. Let's begin by setting up this Google Sheet to solve for any system of linear equations that is 5x5 or smaller. I will be solving a 3x3 matrix in this example though. You could easily adjust this for larger systems of equations by just adding another row and column for every additional independent equation you have. So, let's create a column title and a title for all of our x values. Through this, we will be able to input any matrix coefficients in here and solve the matrix easily. Now, let's go ahead and set up a table with our current values of x in our columns and our number of iterations in our rows. As our matrix of interest here is diagonally dominant, our initial guesses does not matter, and we can therefore just assume a matrix of 0. So, that means that all of our values of x are initially all assumed 0. Just a note, if your matrix is not diagonally dominant, it does not mean that it won't converge. It just means that if your matrix diverges, when your error gets larger and larger with every iteration, you need a better starting guess for your initial x values. To solve a system of linear equations using the Gauss-Seidel method, it is necessary for us to convert each independent equation into an equation that solves for one of our unknown values. Here I have shown you what that looks like for all three of our independent equations. We then need to type in these equations, each column here representing one of our equations. Just note that I am adding a dollar sign for all of the coefficients of our matrices. This is very important as when we iterate our problems later, we also want our cells to refer to these values. If we didn't have the dollar signs every time we drag a cell down, which is how we are iterating, Google Sheets will take the value below the cell that we actually want. You can see what I mean here, it has taken the value below and not the coefficient that we actually want. Now that we have all of our initial x guesses put into our spreadsheet, let's add in a section for each of the independent equations, so that when we check how much error we have at each iteration, this can be done easily by setting all of our equations to 0. By doing it in this way, we can essentially see how far we are off from our true answer with the assumed x values. And that is all you need to do. We can now just extend these columns down, and every row generated is a new iteration. All we have to do now is look to see where our error for all three of these independent equations is, and we have our solution. And these are the x values that provide that. As you can see here, iterative numerical methods are best solved through either Google Sheets, Microsoft Excel, MATLAB, Python, or really any other coding language. This is because iterative numerical methods are very tedious to perform by hand, and very easy to make a mistake with. As mentioned previously, the nice thing about setting up your Google Sheet like this is that we can adjust our matrix however we see fit, and still be able to use it to solve any problem we want using the Gauss-Seidel method. Just be careful of matrices with no solution, which is a singular matrix, and diverging solutions, which, as stated previously, means that we need a better initial guess for our X matrix. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how you can solve linear systems of equations using the Gauss-Seidel method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships or our Patreon down below to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.